In the last video, we looked at the I2C interface. We did not look at what access looks like when several masters start sending at the same time. We will also look at another special feature of the I2C interface, the repeated start condition. Let's start with the repeated start condition. For this example, we use the address 32. The value 5 is written from the master to the slave, then the value 128 shall be read from the slave to the master. We already know how the transmission of the first byte works from the last video. More interesting is the transition to the second data packet. Now the next transmission is initiated with the so-called repeated start condition. For this purpose, the master generates a falling edge on the SDA line while the SCL line is at a high level. This is followed by the address. The read-write bit is now 1. After the transmission of the data bit and the acknowledge bit, the stop condition follows. The bus is now in the idle state again. If there are several masters on the bus, it is possible that two or more masters start the start condition at the same time. In this case, a bus access conflict occurs. With the help of certain mechanisms, it must be automatically decided which master receives the bus access. This is called arbitration. Arbitration is most easily explained with an example. Here you can see the levels on the bus at the top and the levels generated by each individual master below. Arbitration is done with the addresses. The lowest address gets access. Each master checks the SDA line during the high phase of a bit to see if it is actually high. We remember at this point the weak high levels of I2C. If the line is low, the master knows that another master is pulling the SDA line to ground. It has then lost arbitration and withdraws from the bus. The first master loses access to the bus after 2 bits. The second master loses access to the bus after 4 bits. The third master has not noticed the access of the other masters and continues with the transmission. Now you know some of the special features of the I2C bus. Stay tuned, there's more to discover. I'm Thomas with the Institute of Electronics. I hope you have learned something today, but anyways, thanks for watching.